Welcome to this Dacian campaign let's play. This is a kind of Rome 2 countdown campaign, and I'm gonna be playing as the Dacians today. Or Dacians, whatever you wanna call them. Yeah. So, let's start with some early goals, I guess we could say. What do I want first? Cause I don't wanna have to control the entire world right away. I want some starter goals. So I guess starter goals, probably wiping out the Thracians and taking Bilizora over here from the Macedonians should be some good starter goals, and we'll probably get those around the first 10 turns, maybe less. Yeah. Let's get right in. Iron and gold. Yeah, that's good. Iron and gold, iron and gold. I need those things. Mines, roads. Let's get roads. Yeah, and if anyone wonders why I'm doing the Dacians, I've been reading a few books recently, and I figured out Dacians are actually a really interesting culture because they had they lived right here in the Carpathians. Or not Carpathians. Wait. Well, they lived in Transylvania. And they had access to two of the most important resources of the ancient world. One of them is right here, it's gold. And the other one was salt, because that was highly prized because it could cover the taste of bad food, even after it had gone rotten, very old meat and fruit and bread and stuff like that. So it was very valuable and prized in urban cities like Rome, because they had to have giant feasts and their meat went rotten only after a few days, so they needed to cover up the taste of rotten meat for their guests. And so, in history, technically, Emperor Trajan set his sights on the riches of Dacia, and only managed to conquer a bit of it, up to the Danube here, just past the Danube, like, to out here, and then he had to turn back. So really, in real life, no one really truly conquered Dacia, and it was free until the end of the Roman Empire, basically, and then it was overrun by barbarians. But anyways, enough about that. Let's train some units. Let's get an archer warband, and another regular warband. Let's see this guy. Veniza, faction heir. Ooh, he's a good commander. So is Skiles, though. Actually, Veniza is better than Skiles. I might have to, swap them. Oh, so is Xyraxes, but he's the faction leader, yeah. So I don't want to get rid of him just yet. I don't want to lose him. Skiles. I'll keep Skiles as my general. Hopefully he'll improve. So, let's send diplomat down there to secure a peace treaty for now with the Macedonians. And then let's send a spy over towards the Thracian territory of Tylus and Campus Getae, which is up here there, over there by the Scythians. And then we should probably get some more units into Skiles' army. Then for Skiles, probably put some watchtowers down, so that way I can see whenever the Thracians move around here, if the Macedonians trying to cross the river there, I'll be ready for them. And then go back to join Captain Bonat. There's a rebel settlement over here, but that's awfully close to the Julii starting position, so I don't think I'll go for it, because I don't want to spark an early war with the Romans just yet. Okay, let's end turn. Captain Bonat. So what does this army have? Falxman? Wait, nope. Oh great, we're losing money per turn, I think. Oh, that's not it. Oh, yeah, that's bad. Why is it so... Oh, army upkeep, that's the main reason. I need trade agreements then. So I need more infantry in this. Take. Attila. Attila the Hun, working for the Dacians. Traitor. Or Dacians. Oh. Macedonian. Let's make trade rights, map, and map for now. Yeah. It's good because I need the extra money for now. And then I'll head down to the Greeks, I guess. Should be, yeah, right there. Oh, that's bad. Looks like there's two major Thracian armies that have come out of their towns. I don't like that. What is this guy's name? Burabista. That was a king, man. Of the Dacians. He was actually very well known by the Romans. So was Decebalus, the other good, really good guy. Kicked the crap out of the Romans. There's not much to do, I guess, right now. I mean, we only have two territories. Oh, yep, that's bad. That Thracian army's coming. You know what, I'll join you, you two. You can come later. I need to get rid of this Thracian army. There we go. Am I still losing money? Move! Yeah, I am. Great. So I'm in a tight financial situation within the first 5 turns, of course. I guess I need to build those mines really badly. Well, the Thracian army has retreated. I'm assuming because this is the capital, it's going to be quite wealthy, so let's do it. Transgression, yeah. It's a lot of whipping noise. Ah! Ah! Oh, yeah, there's a Greek diplomat. Actually, as many trade rights. Oh, what? Are you serious? Just trade rights? Okay, I don't get trade rights with the Greeks then. That's poo-poo. Where's, Apollonia should be right there. That'll be the Bruti Romans. Oh, yeah, I'm losing money badly. I need Tylus fast. I'm hoping that it gives me tons of money. Also, I'm probably gonna be pretty screwed over all immediately. I'm gonna have no money. I'm gonna have no money. Okay, let's build some rams or Dacian Thracia or Thrace. Don't know what to do. I need, where's Apollonia? I know you're around here somewhere. There you are. Give me trade rights and map. Dude. You kidding me? Let's try it again. Dude, you guys are worthless. What about Aulus? Yeah, he's smart, see? Oh, probably because my diplomat has no influence whatsoever. That's nice. Come on. Poo-poo. Dichomedes, you suck. Or Dichomedes. Now I can't get trade rights with anyone because you're stupid and you can't negotiate. Oh, I'm still building it. This should be a good army. I mean, I have Falxmen. As long as that Thrace army right next to it doesn't attack me, but they probably will. Oh, thank you, Cilia. Can I get map information from you two? Yep. Okay. Thank you, Cilia. You're actually nice to me. What is Thrace doing? Oh, that's bad. He didn't move his... Where did his Tylus army go? I think they went down south to fight the Macedonians. Oh, that's not good. Yeah, that's definitely not good. Oh well. Let's do this. So my Foxmen are going to be definitely the heavy hitters. Siles versus Bizus, or Bizus. Peltas, Militia Cav, Peltas Cav, basically. And the Factionary. Ooh, Factionary, that's good. We got him trapped in the city, too. Let's go. So this should be pretty easy. My Falxmen should be the heavy hitters. Probably annihilate everyone pretty easy. They shouldn't move out of their town square. Just because that's kind of suicidal. Yeah, and I always like watching the battle speeches until they get a little repetitive, and then I don't. So let's just listen to this for a minute. Take up the sword, string your bow. Now we must test our hearts and our courage like men. Okay. That was a okay speech. Wasn't the best. No. My Phalanxmen are not pushing that ram because they're going to get hurt. I would rather have Warband pushing the ram. Okay. Because Warband are worthless. They only have, like, the worst of all defenses possible, wooden gates. Which means they only have a palisade, if I'm correct. Let's bring these archers up. Moving up a little closer. Yeah, I always like the look of the barbarian units. I think they look pretty cool, even though they're all clones. Especially the Falxmen and Bastarni, though. They look pretty freaking awesome. Yep, see, my warbands are already being shot at. So it's a good thing I didn't bring my Falxmen in there with them. Oh no! Man down! Man down! Boom, boom, boom. Yep. Just them and their long oval scutums. I think that's what they're called. At least that's what the legionaries called them. They used to be oval. History fact, if no one knew this. The scutums used to be oval, and then the Romans made them more rectangular for more protection. So just a little fun fact there, for those of you that didn't know that. Yeah, it's a pretty crappy town, but... I mean, it should be really wealthy, so... I mean, I'm hoping it is. There's... Bizus, or Bizus. And then there's Skiles. Skiles! Hopefully he does pretty well, and he can gain some command stars, because... I need him to. Oh yeah, by the way, I didn't show the beginning, but this is on a medium difficulty, because, guys, I kind of suck at this game. I'm not gonna say that I'm terrible, but I mean, I'm just not as good as most other people that play this game. So, let's get in that city. That's what I would say. Get in that city and get those Peltists. Get them Peltists. Yeah, they will. Oh good, I actually managed to catch their Peltas too. Warriors have taken the walls. Now the streets will run with blood. Just need to get my warband in there. What should my archers shoot at? I don't know. I'll wait for them to do anything useful. Oh no, don't go in that way. Oh, whatever. So let's watch some of this combat. Lag. There they go. Bye bye. Let's get him in there. Oh, I should use, before I get into melee with their other dudes, I should use Warcry. Oh, the arrows. Murder. Where are they running to? Where are you running to? Oh, the hills. They just said it. Okay, never mind. What? I look like an idiot. Let's get over there. Yeah, and then let's get my Falxmen in there as well. Just because they're going to be pretty good. Pretty deciding. I've always wondered if this was real. I mean, I've heard from books that Dacians did use, like, scimitar-like swords, but I mean, that might be a little excessive. That might slightly be a little excessive, just saying. Thrace, you dumb nuggets. Oh yeah, and I should also, I know, the last unit that I should get in here, that's Skiles, because morale boost, and, I mean, General's Bodyguard at the beginning game are insanely overpowered against, like, any other cavalry. So, they're pretty useful. Although, I think he has more General's Bodyguard than I do. Yeah, 35. They look lamer, though. So, that instantly gives them a loss bonus. That gives me a win bonus of 500% automatically, just because they look stupid. Oh well. Rally the troops. Skiles. You and your horn. Okay. What are they doing? Let's just watch this. Oh, I should probably also use my Falxman as Warcry for now. Warband. Well, spearmen against cavalry and militia cavalry at that. I think we all knew who's gonna win this. Oh, General. Skiles, I need you. Steady. Yeah, they're fine. They should be fine anyways, but I don't care. I just wanna make sure. There's Byzus, the factionaire of Thrace. Thracia. See, how long does he do? How good does he do? How long does he live? Make your bets, people. Place your bets now. Place your bets. Oh, man. He's starting to get stuck in there. He's having issues. He's stabbing like crazy, though. Oh. Nah, he's surrounded now. Oh! Oh. Dang it. Skiles, no. Oh. Well, that kind of sucked. I just lost Skiles right at the end. He was the only one that died out of his entire unit, you idiot. God, I hate you. So both the generals committed suicide at the same time, basically. Great. Now I have no general. I need another family member to take over. I need someone to come of age, that way they can take over. Okay, let's see how good this does. I need looting, so. Oh, yeah, 1011. That should. Let's see. Financial. No? Wait. Oh, okay, yeah. Whew, okay, we're making money again. That's good. Oh, yeah, there's the main army. Bring Kanos. He's not family. He's not the faction leader, though. Sucks, Skiles. I need another general. Oh, someone just came of age. Duras. Yeah, he kind of sucks, but whatever. I'm assuming that he can do well. Yeah, I just need to get some more money so I can start building things again to increase my income. Oh, Thrace. Are you trying to make me a treaty? No? Oh, that's bad. Ah, no, my reinforcement unit is gone. Oh, yeah, that's bad. Well, it could be worse, I guess. If I can get rid of their Falxmen, because they have no shields and I have archers, if I can get rid of their Falxmen before they can get too close to me, then it should be okay. Oh, wait, but they also have hoplites. Dang it! Well, I lost. No mercy! Yeah. Hey. Don't know what to do here. It's kind of a lost cause already. Whatever. Well, I guess just fast forward this. Yeah, their militia hoplites, those have big shields too. Great. No firewall. I'm gonna just try and get those Falxmen out of here at least. I want to get rid of them because they're heavy. They're hard hitters. I don't like them. I don't want them on Thrace's team. Oh no, I shouldn't be doing that. No. Well, while we've lost already, let's take a look at the scenery. There's a nice little temple over here. No, just out of bounds. Can't get to you. Oh well. What else is there around here? There's a nice forest. It's pretty big. It's a pretty good forest. And I come from Colorado, so I know what big forests look like, trust me. I'm hoping I can get this out today, but it's kind of late, because I got back from Aspen at like 2 o'clock. And then I kind of dilly-dallied around for like another hour. So it's like 3. Let's see the time. 3:45 right now, and mountain time, and this is, I'm still trying to record this, so this could be bad. I might not be able to get it out today. I could get it out Monday, but then I also have the Mountain Blade thing to do. So it'd all go a lot faster if stupid Windows Movie Maker didn't take so long to edit things. Shut up. Yeah. I only wish Windows Movie Maker would actually save it defaultly to one that YouTube could actually use, but no! So then I have to go through a humongous saving process again. So let's watch this. Oh wait, delete key. Delete key, we get a little arrow cam thing. I think. Pretty sure. Right? Oh yep, there's one. Ah! Yeah, it's kinda dumb. Yeah, they're all dying. I need war cry. War cry. Oh yeah, here they come. Charge. I need a charge bonus at least. Oh. Yeah, this is definitely not good. I need a flame. Oh, I actually got him. Wow. Get him. Get him. No, what are you doing? Come back. I need arrows, man. Oh, get back. No. Oh, that's bad. Well, AI is using pretty smart tactics. Using their militia cav against my archers and not my warband. That's not good. Oh, wait, but I just forgot something. Archer warband actually have spears, don't they? Like the Forester Warbands? Oh no, they have knives. Oh, yep, and they went. Well, no, I have no support now. Oh, freaking Peltis, get out of here. I can murder you easily. I'm just gonna try and take as many of them as I can with me. Come on, men. We cannot win today. But take as many as you can with you so that way your comrades can win tomorrow. Oh, my general. He's got a humongous sword. Come on. Don't die to one Peltist. Don't be an idiot and die to one Peltist. Oh, that's a good kill. Oh, that's bad. Double bad. Oh, no. Charge those. You need to get rid of those Falxmen, or else they're going to be major issues. Sorry about that. I just had to talk to my mom for a second. Oh, there is my general. Captain Attila. The Hun. No. It's cunning indeed. Yeah, that wasn't that good. I lost 79 men. Or maybe a little less than that, because they heal casualties. I get the Falxman unit halfway down, so that's good. That's annoying. But I have Tylus. Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, my. What? That's a humongous army. And then, oh, that's a big army, too. What can I recruit here? Nothing. Come on. Can I recruit something? Muster field. It's kind of worthless. Another mine. What kind of mine is this? Oh, another gold mine. Good. Guess I need that though, because I need warband. Well, I gotta say, guys, I think that might have to end it for now, so. Yeah, I guess, I'll see you guys next time, where we, try and clean up this rebel situation and defeat the humongous Thracian army that is just assembled outside of Tylus. Not good. Starnay. But yeah, so yeah. Hope you guys enjoy.